Hello and welcome back to Seaside Garage. I have been working on the Auto Bianchi or Lancia A112. I have done a lot of work off camera, and frankly, I think maybe it's a bit too boring to make videos about because it's just rust cutting out, welding in, and also I'm not that good at rust work, so I don't mind that you don't see all the details involved in that. But if you want to see more details, then please comment, because I can make videos about it if you like. But what I have done since the last video where we put the engine in and started it up and it's working, it's a bit clattery actually, so I need to adjust the valves again, but that is not going to be today. Today I'm going to show you where I'm at with rust work. I still have a long way to go, but I'm closer than ever. I have decided to actually hurry up and finish this car up and not make it completely and not rebuild it or restore it completely, because I'm just not that kind of person. And I just want this car to be driving again. It got number plates on and everything. I'm paying tax and paying insurance and all that on this car, and I just want to get it outside and enjoy it again. But I want the rust, especially in the A-post, to be fixed, because that was actually getting dangerous. I think the car was pretty close at collapsing because of so much strength had been removed. And I would also like to fix all the visual rust on the car. The bottom end still needs some work, but I don't think I'm going to do that this time around. Also, I'm not going to respray the car. It really could use a respray, especially after fixing the rust, but I cannot afford it and I cannot do it myself. So the way I have decided to do it is to do it with spray cans. And I know I can actually make a pretty good job with that. But I also know that I'm always too lazy to prepare. And the most important step when painting a car, especially with paint, no matter what kind of stuff you paint it with, is the preparation. I always fool myself to think that the paint will somehow cover up a scratch or a dent or something like that. It will never cover anything. Everything will just stand out. Anyway, let me show you what I have done so far. So coming from over here in the forest of mopeds, there are mopeds everywhere at the moment. Let's take a look at the car. I cut off the front fender the other day. I still need to cut the rest of it off. I'm cutting it off in pieces to actually take it apart slowly, not to destroy the inside where I need to weld the new wing on. And so far so good, it's not that bad. Up here it's pretty solid. It was completely gone in the other side. This part was just as bad as the other side. So I have made a new panel for this entire part that goes down here. I have bent it and welded in. It is not beautiful, but it is solid, very solid. So that's good. Then the A-pillar, I tried to find a new A-pillar for the car as I did on the other side. I just welded the entire A-pillar in on the other side, but I have had no luck. So I took it apart and actually realized that it was not in that bad of a condition compared to the other side. The outer skin was pretty rotten, but the inside, the important bit, the structural parts inside, was solid. So I have just cleaned that up, and then I have started to weld up some new skin for this, just to protect it. I still need to dress it up, and I also need to make some small repairs inside of here. And I need this to fix this entire lower panel. I'm gonna cut a piece out of this and weld on, because it's a bit hole down here. And also I have a hole in the panel. Oh, this is pretty dark, but right here. So this will be all right. It's not going to be beautiful, but it's going to be solid and nice. I am trying to find some rear wheel arches, because it's not that difficult to make this part, but then it comes out like this and then turns one time and goes down a little bit and then turns in again and goes in. So it's a bit complicated to bend this, especially when you are a complete amateur and don't have much tools for it. So I hope to find something If not, then I will have to make it out of many pieces, one piece here, and then a small one here, and small one here, and then weld it all back together. That is going to be time consuming and difficult, and most likely it won't look very nice, but that doesn't really bother me because there is a body kit going on top of it. So no matter how I fix it, it won't be visible. Actually, I could slam the body panel on again, and then you wouldn't be able to know that it was rusty, but I know, and I want to fix it. I also still need to take off the rear bumper and check the condition underneath there. I expect rust to be there as well, of course. But let's take a look at the other side. I actually got some comments from you guys about this car being in the background when I made other videos about the mopeds and stuff. And some of you commented, hey, the front wing is on. Hey, it's got primer. Hello, Sean Murray. And yes, actually quite a lot of progress has been made off camera. And let me show you where I'm at the moment. So last time around, this car had no front wing. Now there is a front wing. And also I actually painted it with rattlecans. Firstly, I put on a primer and then the paint and then a clear coat. And it is not at all perfect, but I actually am pretty happy with the result. Especially the color seems to match fairly well, and that's a very difficult thing. It's easy enough to find the paint coat for cars. It's pretty difficult to find places that are able to mix the paint coat correctly. Apparently, and also paint tends to change color over time. This paint is 35 years old, so. But I think the color match is pretty close on at the moment. This side is completely clean. This side is very, very dirty, and it needs to be polished. And I think when it is polished, it will match up pretty well. Looking at the viewfinder in the camera, the difference looks a little bit easier to tell than in real life, but I think the result is pretty good. But as I said just before, I am always too lazy when doing this. I was really building up to do this proper, and I was thinking about how to make sure no dust was in the garage and the temperature was right and everything was dry and all that. And then suddenly I saw myself standing out here in the garage, actually in slippers and in shorts. I was just going out to take a look at the, I always do that late night, just go out and look at all my stuff and then go in again. And then suddenly I took a rattle can and then I just started painting, and it was completely spontaneous, and yeah, it shows, but it's a lot better than I would have thought actually. And it makes me think that the other side is going to be pretty good, because I know where I failed and I know that the result could be pretty good with this paint. I just need to be a bit more careful. Maybe I will redo this side, but really I don't think so. But there is one issue that is quite big. The other is all right. Let's take a look at it. This is going to be, I don't know if it picks up on the camera, but you can see maybe right here that I have been using a too coarse sandpaper, and I should have used some finer sandpaper. I don't really know what grade you should go to before painting a car. I know that if you go too low or too high, actually, if it gets too smooth, the paint won't really grab onto the metal. So you don't have, you cannot just go to 2500 sandpaper or something like that. There is a limit, but this is too coarse, I think. Another thing that is very common when I paint stuff is preparation. I had a runner and some liquid filler that I did not sand down enough. And also the filler is visible up here a little bit, right there, for instance. So it is not perfect. And some annoying bug also landed in the paint right here. But all in all, this is not bad, in my opinion. I know some of you would think that this is a complete waste of time and a shame for such a nice car to be painted with rattle cans, but this is my car, this is my project, and if I had to pay other people to do this for me, then I can't really see the reason why I should do it, because remember, the thing I enjoy the most is being in my garage and fix stuff, and I would like to do all of it myself. And I know when doing that, I will make a lot of mistakes and a lot of things would be better if I got some professional to do it. But where's the fun in that? That is just how I'm wired. But one kind of big problem is this. This front fender is not from the Model 7 Lancia A112. It's from the Model 5, I think. I was told that it didn't matter much other than the fact that there was a big hole right here for the indicator. I have welded that up, so that is all right now. Also, that is covered by the bumper. But these holes right here should apparently not have been there, because when I fit this trim piece to the car, it's supposed to be right there. It doesn't cover that hole right there. So that would not have been a big problem if I had noticed it before painting the car, because I could have just welded that hole up. Now it's a bit of a problem. I haven't really decided what to do, but I think I will end up welding it up and then paint from this line and down. That will be visible for sure. It's so hard to blend in. It's a bit easier when you can go from edge to edge on a surface, in my opinion. But that is just how it goes. This mistake I will not do on the other side. And also I will take a bit more care with the coarseness of the sandpaper. There we go, it's not that bad. Unfortunately, I do not know where to get this trim tape that should go all the way up here. So I haven't really decided about what to do with that. If it was only the red stripes, then I could paint it with a brush, but it's another color in between as well, so that would be a bit difficult. I don't know, maybe just remove it entirely, maybe just let it be as it is. I don't know. I can't remember if I showed you this, but I have also fixed the door bottom ends. And again, it is not perfect. And I have not used a lot of time sanding or filled it up or anything like that, because there will be a plastic trim over it. And I don't really care much about how it looks underneath that. I just need it to be sound and I need it to be rust free, then I'm all right with it. And the rear wheel arch still needs to be fixed on this side. Then I also have a little bit of an issue right here with some rust. It's solid enough, but it's rust. So even though I haven't put up a lot of videos lately, I have actually been doing quite a lot of work in the garage. I don't know if it's interesting to make videos about these small stuff and very repeatable stuff with rust work and paint and all that. If you would like to see more details about it, then please comment, then I will consider making some more videos along the way. If not, then I will just finish it up and then show you the end results of stuff. I need this car back on the road, because this car is too much fun to have standing around in a garage, especially when the summer is here. So yeah, thank you for watching and see you in the next one.